let's do a little myth busting about systems thinking. What systems thinking is not is just about being organized. Can I add A plus B plus C plus D? It's definitely a piece of systems thinking, but it goes much further.
System thinking is not thinking systematically. So if I were to think systematically through 10 different subsystems of a vehicle, and for each of those subsystems, I would ask the question of, what is the noise contribution to the overall vehicle in this subsystem? And I would sort of add the noise for those different subsystems up. That would certainly be thinking systematically through the vehicle. I'd be going through an enumerated or complete list of all the subsystems. But what's fundamentally missing is I'm not thinking about the vehicle as a system. I'm not thinking about it as a whole and having some behavior or properties or functionality that must be treated holistically at the top level rather than at the decomposed level. Let me define a system as a set of pieces that have relationships, which performs a function. So I could talk about three bricks sitting on a table. Are these a system? Well, do they have some relationship between them? Not necessarily. I could talk about three subsystems of an aircraft, the wing, the fuselage, and the engines. Do they have some shared function? Yes, flying people from A to B. What I need to add to my definition of systems is that the pieces and their relationships work to produce some functionality or performance that is greater than the parts individually. And I'm going to call that emergence. What does this mean in terms of systems thinking? It means that I'm going to take a series of blocks and I'm going to analyze, well, what are all the blocks that are in the system? What are all their relationships? And how do we use the knowledge of the blocks and their relationships in order to understand what kind of emergence I'm likely to see out of it?
It's kind of like playing a chess game. You really have to think 10 moves ahead. It starts with, what is this invention going to be used for? What's its purpose? And then it moves into, how are we going to assemble the pieces and parts to make it work? And then eventually, how will we build it? How will we be able to make it work continuously? It's really seeing the whole chessboard. During that creative, inventive process, that's systems thinking.